Oh, man, I hate Mondays.
Nah, man, it's Tuesday.
Wait. What day is it?
You know what day it is. Tuesday. Brewsday Tuesday.
Oh, fuck yeah. It's time for Brewsday Tuesday, brought to you by the Cellar and Six Pack Store. Here is Huck and Big Nate.
Still haven't gotten my timing down, Huck.
Yeah, well, I'm still like Huck and Big Nate.
Yeah, that's what it is. Hearing my own name throws me off.
Who's this Big Nate we speak
You should have seen me in school.
Oh.
Big Nate? Hell, what do?
Well, you're in the middle of the class then. You know, Ian, I was B, so my real last name starts with a B.
Buzz. Usually it's a first name.
Huck. I wasn't Huck then. So,
Huck's Beer Buzz. Your parents were prophets.
They were. So, yeah, he named me Huck's Beer Buzz. So, here we are. We are now some more beer from my trip. So, these are Alabama beers. Went to a place in Alabama. We're just riding up the road. We do this. Liz looks on the one of the camping places, and she finds this really cheap campground in Gadsden, Alabama Nakalula Falls.
Nakalula Falls.
Right. It's a city campground. It's got like waterfall hookups, $17 a night, which is really cheap.
Yeah, that is cheap.
Trails, one of the trails goes under the waterfall. I did not do that. We'll talk about some hiking later. I got two there. I was already wore out. I was like, no way. And then I ended up having to climb a cliff, but I'll tell you that in a minute. So anyway, there were a couple of breweries in town, and they were, you know, definitely okay. I think we're going to have a beer from one of them at least. But I went to the multi-tap bar, and where we got the beers from last time, and he told me to go to this Shell station. So I go to this Shell station, and I'm like, whoa. They had like a complete shelf, like a whole rack of Alabama beers. So I bought a whole bunch of them.
I love those moments when you run into it, because you never think, like, you go into the gas station to buy some beer. You think, yeah, maybe they'll have like some Sierra Nevada, something, whatever. I should have planned better and, you know,
right,
gone to the Cellar restaurant and six pack store and
right, got some real
my beer or something. But I always love when you go in and like they've got like a legit beer cave. It's like the rest of the store is just dirty, dingy, but you go to the back, you walk through those doors, and it's like, it's like that scene in the movie where the choir of angels come.
I remember about
I'm envisioning you having that moment. Your hair gets blown back.
Well, no, I knew what I was going. You know, they told me where to go. But I remember the first time I ever saw, like, in the door of the Sheets Bear Cave, like a two-hearted ale. And I went, uh-oh, what's going on? Looks like the big boys have figured it out.
Man, I mean, now they've moved on to brewing their own beers.
I know. We're going to get some of that.
They, I was just over there. They've got Project Happy Holidays, which I think was their holiday beer that probably didn't sell so great.
That'll be fresh now.
Donut hole beer. I don't know. I think beer should be beer and donut holes should be donut holes, but so we can find out on a later episode.
There you go. So I'm drinking the Invisible Swordsman, and it's from a brewery called Singing River. And according to the internet, it is in just looked it up.
How do they know he has a sword if he's invisible?
Well,
is there just a sword flying through the air, or
it's a little weird. They're in Florence, Alabama. We haven't really talked about this. We'll do a whole show on this, but like stealing intellectual property. So it has the Three Amigos.
It does have the Three Amigos.
And then it has the Nightmare Before Christmas skull head people. Okay, so they really went out there. I'm sure there's an invisible swordsman somewhere that's gonna, you know, be part of that. But they all have guns, so I don't know where the swordsman is. Let's see. Invisible swordsman is going to guide you and your amigos down this busty trail.
Busty?
Busty. Dusty. That's... Dusty, sorry.
Okay.
It's like
that's
like
a whole different trail, Huck.
It's a real...
It's another show, frankly.
Real funny font, and it's small. So what are you drinking?
I have got the Red Hare Brewing Company. It's a India Pale Ale blended with grapefruit flavored juice. It's their grapefruit SPF 50/50 and India Pale Radler. Now, I've had Radlers before. I've not had India Pale.
No, yeah. Rather. This is an example of somebody reaching a little too far when they're trying to do something. Well, let's just make it into a Rattler. It's IPA. Let's change it into a Rattler. What do you think?
I don't know.
Yeah.
On the front end, not that bad.
But the back end?
That grapefruit juice may have turned.
Oh. I tried to keep them refrigerated.
Yeah, I don't think it's you. Nope. Here it is. Grapefruit flavored juice.
Oh, it wasn't even
real. They went to Welch's and were like, yeah, we need some of your grapefruit flavored juice.
What was the name of that brewery? Let's see what they look like.
The Red Hare Brewing Company. Hare, H-A-R-E, like the tortoise and the hare.
There it is.
There's no hare in it.
Oh, they're actually out of Georgia. See, I messed up there. Sorry.
They came from Alabama. You brought this beer from Alabama.
I did bring this beer from Alabama.
Their logo looks like their artwork on the can looks like something you would see in a dentist's office.
Yeah, it does look a little weird.
I think.
And if they're from Marietta,
getting my teeth, why do they have the ocean in there? That. Yeah, come on, surfing's not big in Marietta.
So let's see, they're Marietta, Georgia's the 7-year-round beverages. This is one of them. Oh, a tangerine. Oh, they have several. Rewired IPA, SPF, tangerine, CDL, soft J IPA. I see a kind of thing here. And they have one in North Carolina. Oh, Alabama. Oh, so they distribute in Alabama. There, fair enough.
Yeah, that's enough.
I mean, you know.
They committed enough to Alabama to distribute there.
I was in Georgia and couldn't find any beer, so I went to Florida and I wanted to go on our way this whole trip. I wanted to go to Aardwolf Brewing in Jacksonville, and they were closed the day we were there, Monday. So that's a shame. A lot of the breweries close on Monday. Lots of old people who don't have to work like to drink on Mondays.
Yeah, that's something conflict. I've noticed. Every time I crave my favorite pizza shop here locally, every time I crave pizza, it's a Monday and they're closed. And it's always just baffled the hell out of me.
Well, I get it. You know, they want a day off. I was in the food service industry for a long time, and my weekend was Monday, Tuesday. You get off Sunday night, get hammered, and do something for the next 2 days. Mostly your laundry and shopping.
That was another one. I worked night shift.
I did two years of straight midnight shift.
You feel like a degenerate when you're rolling up to the store and buying beer at 7 a.m. because, well, that's the evening for you. You're getting off clock.
Yeah, I lived in Richmond, and I'd get off at 7, and there's a sub place out there in the West End, and I would drive out there, and they'd serve beer and subs at 7:00, 7:30 a.m, but they also serve breakfast. So I'd be sitting there with a pitcher of beer, eating some kind of jalapeno steak sub, and everybody'd be looking at me pretty funny.
Well, yeah, and then you know, daggone well, every employee there is asking their manager why the hell we're open, and he says to them, "We're doing it for Huck.
Huck, he's coming in.
We've got to be here for him."
That's right. Needs a pitcher. So this shirt I've got.
Yes, let's talk about the shirt because
you can't see it, but it's basically a blue shirt with a piece stripe of white paint down the middle.
Yeah, it's very simple, very subtle, and I'm actually ashamed that I didn't pick up on it. But no, neither did anyone else in the room. So let's talk about that.
So, and it leads into what I want to talk about. So this is a Appalachian Trail shirt, and it basically has the white blaze, and it's just, you know, people either get it or they don't get it. And it's funny, I wear it around and some people go, "Oh, I love the trail." And some people go, "What is that?"
Yeah, it's definitely it's kind of like when you run into somebody you haven't seen, except for like in work, you run to them outside of work and then you're unsure, is that? That's what happened with the shirt. But I figured it out. So you had something you wanted to talk about that was going to lead into.
Yeah, so at the Nakalula Falls, they had a hike. So I go the first day. And I hike over to the fall. I just walk over the falls. It's like a quarter mile from the campsite. And I go around, and they had this whole Christmas light thing. So the whole other side's blocked off. So that was the first night. So the next morning I got up and I said, "Well, I don't think I'm going to go for a walk." So I look on the little brochure, and sure enough, well, actually, I had to go to the office every day because we just came for one night. And they were like, "Can we have another night?" And then, "Can we have another night?" You know, because it was so great. So the second day I go out. I think we went around town and came back around 4 p.m. So I walk down, and there's this bridge. I find the bridge, and there's a trail on the other side and a trail on this side. So I take the trail down towards the falls upstream, and it's pretty rough. I mean, it was difficult. Difficulty of, I'd say, is 6 or 7 out of 10. Mm. And then when I get to the end, I climb down, and here's this huge cavern under the falls, and the trail goes through. And I'm like, well, I don't want to do that. I think I'll just bail out. This guy and this girl are standing there, and like, no, you won't. I said, well, what do you mean? They go, you can go back or you can go around, and it's about the same distance either way. So I'm like, man, that is. So I turn around, and I noticed when I was walking that, but right before I started down the steep part, I saw people to the left up in the rocks. So I walked back to where they were, and there was the guy was still sitting there. And I said, can I go up this way? He goes, sure you can. And he goes, looks at me a minute, and he goes, why don't I come down and help you? And I was like, I don't usually accept that, but I'm like, yes, because I'm really old and I'm a little tired here.
Well, yeah. And then at that point,
he didn't have to touch me, but he told me where to put my feet and hands, and I made it.
I mean, that's important sometimes. We have the shadiest hiking trip I ever went on was at the Cascades. I love going up to the Cascades. Nice little day trip, do some hiking, but it rained for like an entire like week and a half beforehand. And you know, I'd figured, maybe the trail is a little watery or whatever.
I've done that hike.
We were waterfall climbing.
Yeah.
Like there's active water flowing. My wife, who was my fiance at the time, I'm trying to help her up. And I'm like, we could very easily die at the Cascades, and then we're going to be on the news and look like morons. We made it.
We go to the Cascades, my daughter and I, all the time. There's five places when it's heavy rain that you're swimming upstream. There's five places. And the top is a waterfall. Yep. Literally comes down the rocks on the path.
I mean, looking back, I'd do it again. It was so much fun, but I've always been a little reckless.
So want to rate these? And
yeah, let's untap these. Of course, you're Huck's Beer Buzz on Untapped. I am Horror Show Radio. Give us a follow. I'm gonna let you go first. I've already got mine locked in, but I'll let you go first.
Okay, so this is a Mexican lager, which for those of you who don't know what that style is, we call it the Dos Equis of beers. Now, that being said, this one's not skunked, and I'm gonna guess partially because it's in a can, not a bottle. So it's actually, for that style of beer, this is very tasty. I mean, I don't like the skunk beers. I mean, I don't drink Heineken. I'm not big on Molson. Any of the skunk beers I stay away from, but this is really kind of crisp and good. I get the Mexican flavor thing. I'm gonna give it a 4. It's not a bad beer.
Not bad, not
bad.
The
Invisible Swordsman.
So this one here, it's the Red Hare SPF 50-50. They went half on the, it seems like the entire project. For me, on a scale of 5, it gets a 2.5.
Ooh.
And I think that's my lowest score so far. But it's not the worst beer I've ever had. But, I mean, it's not breaking the top 50.
Yeah, well, I've given 0.5, so. Yeah, not the worst beer you're going to get, probably.
Yeah, but that's going to do it for the Grapefruit SPF 50-50. This will be my first and last.
You going to play the Alabama Fight song or something?
I was thinking maybe a little Old Crow Medicine Show, Alabama High Test.
There you go.
105.3 The Bear. This is Brewsday Tuesday. We'll roll on after the tunage. Brought to you by The Cellar Restaurant and Six Pack Store.